there's nothing else you can do but be inspired by music that is original and pure and comes from its source. Hip hop should die before I wake. I put an extended all day. Roller every station, wreck the DJ. Roller every station, wreck the DJ. If hip hop should die before I wake, I load an extended all day. Roller every station, wreck the DJ. Roller a station, wreck the DJ. Hip hop to me has made an impact to more genres, more races of people than any other music culture on the planet.
As a culture, it's everything. It's just the hip hop groove kind of paved the way for everything else.
Growing up, I think all we used to do is look to the US because like hip hop originated from America, so that's where you look to for your inspiration.
People would wear academics tracksuits and Echoes tracksuits, and to them it was just like, this is what we wear, this is what we do. But really, those styles, they came from the Bronx.
They've got like maybe 40 years on us. I don't know if they're 40 years ahead, but they've seen each other's mistakes. You've had the generation who done the bad deals. You've got the generation who've done the good deals and been able to benefit from those things.
What gave American hip-hop its credibility is that Nas was mainstream with Illmatic, the most authentically hip-hop record. Wu-Tang was selling millions of records with 36 Chambers, a record that sounds like it was made in hell. We've never had that here, where the mainstream has been brave enough really to really try and support and sell authentically underground MC-based music. Now we can just ignore them completely. Many of us, including myself, are literally touring the world based off our fan base on internet. You don't want to play us on the radio, no beat.
Nah, nah, that's not me. Act like a waste man, that's not me. Sex any girl, nah, that's not me. Lips any girl, nah, that's not me. Yeah, I used to wear Gucci, I put it all in the bin, cause that's not me. True, I used to look like you, but dressing like a mess, nah, that's not me.
Fast forward now, years down the line, we have a lot of power. A lot of them are looking at us now to see what we're doing.
It's that 140 beat. It's like when we were doing all them sets back in the day, spitting all that stuff. Meek and Nat's doing that now. It is the same, it's just that they've got the accent and we've got this accent.
How do you think we can be American better than Americans? We can't. What we can do is add a whole new, unique voice, and I think this is unquestionably the most successful point in Black British music for MCs. And that has come primarily because of the internet. That's the reality. And entrepreneurship.
Just looking at Rockefeller and what Jay-Z done, like, that was my template. That was my template as to say, rah, I can do the same thing with my friends here. You know, we was doing that on a smaller scale in the hood.
Some of us don't need labels and whatnot, and we've got a good attitude here. You know what I'm saying? We're not really relying on anyone to make things happen.
Someone like Stormzy to come out as an anomaly and show people that you can do this without a major label and without huge financial backing, just with good music and a dream and passion, has shown a whole world that actually you can make your dream happen and it can be grand if that's what you want.
Man, try to say he's better than me. Tell my man, shut up.
Shut up.
Mention my name in your tweets. Aruba, shut up.
Shut up.
How can you be better than me? Shut up.
Shut up.
The best in the scene. Tell my man,
shut
look,
up.
Come man, call me a backup dancer. On stage of the Brits, I'm a backup dancer. If that makes me a backup dancer, I'll demand in your face.
It's the best time now, and it's important time now for UK urban music because I remember when we never had no platforms.
If someone hit a mil over here, like underground I'm talking about, hit a million views, it was like a big thing. And now people are like hitting a million views like it's nothing because more and more people are starting to like tune in and watch.
People are starting to realise now that hip-hop and grime is a way to speak to the youth and get your message across.
There are so many great American hip-hop albums that you can't even count them. And I think in the UK we need to now focus on, now that we've got this moment and this heat, on creating those great bodies of work.
To build it to something, to make it worth something. Because we've never been rated as anything from anyone. And that's why we're taking our stuff and going and doing it ourselves.
This is England, this is England, where you can be a villain or a victim.
You've got one movement in the UK that's allowed to accumulate millions.
Major, major stiff stuff. And it's only going to get bigger and better because, look, the future is more diverse now.
Music is really all we've got. It's the only thing that we own that's ours that can't be infiltrated.
I definitely feel like we have got the opportunity to put the UK on the map, like, internationally.
This is England, this is England, where you can be a villain or a victim, where you make money, make it out, avoid pen, that's the idiot's guide to the man of my friend.